Hello everyone, my name is Greg Otto and I'm here with FedScoop TV, and we're at the Adobe Digital Government Assembly today, and I'm here with Doug VanDyke, the Public Sector General Manager for Amazon Web Services. Doug, thanks for talking to us today.
Thank you for the invitation to be here.
Talk to us about the progress that the government is making with their digital initiatives in 2015. Are they keeping up with the private sector or are they falling behind? Where are we on that?
Sure, I'll start with a little history lesson. So Amazon Web Services launched our first service in 2006, and it was about 4 years before the Recovery Board launched recovery.gov on Amazon Web Services. So that was 2010. And I think at that point, the light bulb went off for the federal government. We now have over 900 federal customers using our Amazon Web Services. And what I think is the government is realizing is that they're able to keep up with the innovation that's happening in the private sector. So by using a cloud environment like Amazon Web Services, they have access to the same agile environment. They can scale at the same level of the technical startups in Silicon Valley and the same DevOps that are being used by the tech startups as well. So I think the cloud is going to be the great equalizer, keeping government on pace with the innovations in the private sector.
Where do you think industry could better assist the government? I know Amazon and a lot of other cloud companies have done a lot at getting the government caught up to where the private sector is today, but how can industry help push government further?
Well, it's going to happen through continuous dialogue. And I think that as part of that continuous dialogue, the government needs to, you know, help the industry understand what their mission is, but the industry really needs to help the government understand what technologies are available. I think a really good way to do this is through case studies and best practices. So when government and industry partner and they get something right, make that widely known. A good example is how the Department of Education is using Adobe Connect on Amazon Web Services for internal education and internal meetings. And, you know, making that case study available for others in the government to use will help the government stay up to par with the private sector.
Do you have another example of where the government is leveraging the best technology possible at the time being?
Yeah, a good example is with the Department of Health and Human Services. And it's all across the department. So the reason why I mentioned Health and Human Services is they were the agency that sponsored Amazon through the FedRAMP ATOs. So we have a FedRAMP ATO for both our government region, GovCloud, as well as our East and West commercial regions. They also have great case studies that are publicly available, starting with the National Institutes of Health, the Thousand Genomes Project, CDC, BioSense 2. And the last one I'll highlight is the FDA. It was costing them $29 per report to process, so just under $3 million. By moving this application to Amazon Web Services, now these reports are machine readable with 99.7% accuracy. They've driven the cost down to 25 cents per report. So they've taken their cost from almost $3 million down to $25,000 per year. So it's an amazing efficiency, and I think just overall the Department of Health and Human Service is understanding the benefits that they're going to see with the cloud.
Great stuff. Doug, thank you very much for taking some time out to talk with us today.
Thank you as well.
You can check out all of our videos on our YouTube channel or check out FedScoop TV. My name is Greg Otto. Thanks for watching.